New Zealand has 12 active volcanoes that we monitor as part of the GNS program. A plate tectonic setting creates these volcanoes, which are unique features of the landscape, and they attract thousands of visitors per year. Volcanoes are awe-inspiring, but they're hazardous in an eruption. Monitoring volcanoes allows us to understand how active a volcano is and what the likelihood is that it could erupt in the near future. We inform our key stakeholders so they can make decisions based on that information and maybe actions that they might need to take. Volcanic activity is driven by magma. As this magma rises to shallow levels, gases and fluids from it interact with the volcano's hydrothermal system. This can create seismic, chemical, thermal, and visual indicators of activity, as well as ground deformation. These indicators give us insights into what may be happening in a volcano. We use several techniques to collect data to monitor volcanic activity, and oftentimes we use remote monitoring stations like this.
There's a range of equipment that our field stations may have. We use seismometers for ground shaking, we monitor ground deformation, we have acoustic sensors to detect a volcanic blast,
spectrometers for volcanic gases, and we have data loggers recording temperatures and levels of volcanic features such as crater lakes, fumaroles and hot springs. We also have a network of cameras that provide visual confirmation of any activity occurring on the surface.
Some data, like volcanic gas samples, need to be collected manually at a volcano. This can be done either by gas measurement flights or directly sampling fumaroles or crater lakes. These gas samples are analysed in our labs, and importantly, they tell us if fresh magma is moving in the volcano and interacting with the hydrothermal system.
Many of our monitoring sites are in harsh volcanic environments. Because of this, the sites need to be robust enough to continuously operate for long periods of time.
Near active volcanic vents, however, solar panels can lose their effectiveness from the shadowing effect from a denser plume, from ash in the air, and from ballistics damaging the solar panels. Keeping instrumentation and other electronics operational in volcanic environments has its challenges. The areas can be highly corrosive, so we take steps to seal the electronics away from the air as best as possible and use materials that can better withstand the harsh environment. Our remote infrastructure monitoring team maintain the sites in order to keep the data flowing so it can be available for the National Geohazards Monitoring Centre, our duty officers and scientists.
Our monitoring data helps us set the volcanic alert level for each of the volcanoes. We collect all of that information to tell us about the state of unrest of the volcano, or if it's an eruption, how that eruption is progressing. All of this data collectively allows us to understand the state of the volcano, and the information that we provide from that comes through in the Volcanic Activity Bulletin. This is our way of communicating the status of the volcano at any given time. Every little piece of data we collect and interpret helps us to understand more about how volcanoes work. In addition to monitoring volcanoes for their scientific benefit, the information that we provide plays a key role in keeping people safe.